I am putting in place new provincial health officer orders for all individuals, places of work, and businesses in communities within the Vancouver Coastal and Fraser Health regions.
It's official. The Internet Championship mini tournament next week at Tougher Than Leather has been canceled. Dr. Bonnie Henry gave the order just a little while ago. No non-essential travel from the lower mainland, yada yada. You've heard the pandemic spiel since March. That means no Malik Malone, no Miles DeVille, no Javico, and no that guy, Danny Deeds, as the inaugural Internet Champion raising the belt high above my head. So I'm fired up, and for the next week, I'm still going to rant at you, because there's still going to be a show, and when I get my hands on that belt one day soon, I'm going to cram it down each and every one of your throats, because I'm already the champion of the goddamn internet.
Hello, everyone. It is Tuesday Night TalkDown time. I am Mad Dog Marty Sugar, and we are building to Tougher Than Leather, Big West Wrestling's 9th anniversary party. And as you saw in our opening piece, Dr. Bonnie Henry has made several strict changes to the Fraser Health area, the Lower Mainland, and several of our competitors will not be able to attend. Three of our matches do not get affected at all, but Chucky Lee Ray will be looking for an opponent. We'll discuss that later. We are also going to have a very special new segment called Mailbag. That'll be fun, but it's coming up later.
Family!
Happy birthday to Big West Wrestling from the family.
Happy birthday and happy anniversary from Sky, I, and everybody else in the family. 9 years, been so long, but so short at the same time. What's even shorter is just 1 year. As we've proved here in the family, a lot of things can happen in just 1 year. As a matter of fact, we're gonna make some manifestation predictions. In 1 year from now, I see Big West Gold once again reigning within the family, right where it belongs. What do you think about that, Sky?
Mm-hmm.
Delicious. Happy anniversary and happy birthday, Big West Wrestling, from all of us in the family.
Hey everyone, this is Raven Lake. I just wanted to pop on and send a quick congratulations and a happy anniversary to Big West Wrestling. Happy 9th anniversary. I can't believe it's been 9 years already. It's been a pleasure to work with you guys and for you guys. And I can't wait to see what you have in store for us for the future. Happy anniversary.
9 long years Big West Wrestling has been around. So come on everybody, let's sing a little song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Big West Wrestling. Happy birthday to you. Woo! Happy birthday, Big West Wrestling.
Big West Wrestling fans, it is I, All Attitude Ace Redmond Jr., saying happy 9th birthday to Big West Wrestling. See, Big West Wrestling has been my home over the years, and while I've traveled on to other places, there's always no place like home. So thank you, Big West Wrestling.
Wasn't that a sweet message from Ace Redmond Jr.? Sometimes a kid still shows that he's a good kid, and he's come so far in such a short time. But just in case you forgot what he's really like, take a look at this.
Big West Wrestling fans, it's your boy, All Attitude, Ace Redmond Jr. And there's a global health crisis on the horizon. The fact that All Attitude isn't considered in the Internet Championship Tournament. What the heck, man? I'm the longest reigning television champion of all time. I'm one of the most dominant tag team wrestlers the Okanagan has ever seen. And I have the best win rate of 2020 over any other professional wrestler in the Okanagan. Yet, I'm not in the title picture? That doesn't even make sense. So this Saturday, November 14th, All Attitude is showing up. because I was booked on the card anyway, but I'm showing up to remind you why I deserve to be the brand new Big West Wrestling Internet Champion. Okay?
Shut up and sit down. The World Order. November 14th, Tougher Than Leather Big West Wrestling will celebrate their 9-year anniversary. And from the bottom of our dope-filled hearts, Dylan Murphy and the DWO want to say congratulations to Marty Sugar and the rest of the Big West crew.
Happy birthday, Big West Wrestling! You're 9 and you're feeling fine! Thank you for doing such a good justice to the British Columbia pro wrestling scene. But I do know one thing that would make you better. And I know you're going to get better and keep growing, but there's one thing that would make you that much better. You need a dose of the R.E.D. Because that would be dope. Hope to see you soon.
November 14th at the Summerland Youth Center, it's me versus Slave. And this is a match I've been looking forward to for a long, long time. You see, ever since I was 14 years old, I've watched Slave in the Schubert Center, Lake City Bowling, messing people up left and right, tearing flesh, breaking bones. But that doesn't scare me. On November 14th at Tougher Than Leather, I'm not just gonna prove that I'm tougher than leather. I'm gonna prove that I'm tougher than a homicidal maniac. So I look forward to it, Slave. Bring everything you've got.
Just because I'm not gonna be in Summerlin next weekend doesn't mean I'm not gonna deliver on what I said I would do, and that's talk the talk, walk the walk, be the internet champion, hype the show, hype the brand, and talk about the people. Your entertainment provider, Justin Sider. I'm sure you're pretty happy that a guy like me isn't going to be there next week so you can get in some more ring time. I can appreciate you've been working hard on your craft, but the fact is, your balls are gone. You had 2 great big balls. They were wonderful balls. Everybody salivated about your balls. Marty Sugar gave you these balls, and you ran with them. Tuesday night talkdown, Thursday night throwdown. Justin Sider had the set of balls, and he was leading the pack, and it was wonderful. And then he was stripped of his internet championship label from this fantasy land he was living in, and now he's crawled under a rock, he's put his balls down, and some guy has run over with a really loud truck Justin Sider's balls. And now he's cutting green screen promos identical to Ace Redmond Jr.'s green screen promos, where it's choppy and it's slightly outlined, and it's a half-ass effort with the little app logo in the corner. What happened to you? Where is the family? Is everything falling apart? Your ego's up here where Danny Deeds is, but really, you're down here on your knees where you should be. You know what I'm saying. Justin Sider, why don't you crawl out from the can you're drinking from, get some fire, and I don't care if it's cutting on Ace Redmond Jr., I don't care if you're going to wait for Tuesday night talkdown, Thursday night throwdown, if you want to be a champion of the internet, put my name in your mouth or my future championship in your mouth. Then the least you could do is pick your balls back up and somehow try to work them all back together. Or at least make wine out of them, drink that shit out, spit it in our faces. Justin Sider, your entertainment provider. Family!
Alrighty, everybody, like we said, 9th anniversary. You saw Danny Deeds flipping out right there. What else is new for Danny Deeds? He plans to rant and rave all week. And we, you know what, we appreciate all that he does, despite his horrible attitude, despite his ugly mug. We appreciate all the work he has done for Big West Wrestling over the years. One of the most decorated, most influential, most important wrestlers. One of the pillars of the Big West Wrestling scene.
Happy birthday, Big West Wrestling. It's your K5 medallion holder, Camaro Cope, the Northern Nightmare. And I know a lot of you have accused me of slinking in the shadows and lurking in the darkness lately, but come November 14th, Summerland, British Columbia, for you, Big West Wrestling, I have a beautiful, beautiful surprise, and it all will come to light. happy birthday from me and the K5 medallion.
What to say? What to say? I don't know what to say. See, I can't be like Danny Deeds and blame Dr. Bonnie on the fact that I didn't get an invite myself or Todd Quality. Oh, no. No, 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 no. There was just no invitation for Todd and I to the party to begin with. So, I guess I'm just going to say happy birthday. Todd, you got anything to say?
Happy birthday, Big Wes.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your buddy Handsome Pete. Big West Wrestling, happy 9th birthday. I'm glad I'm still around.
As you can see with that clip with Handsome Pete, his arms in a cast, we're going to show you a clip here. What happened to Handsome Pete back at our October 25th show? What happened at the 2 p.m. and the 6 p.m. shows? Horribly assaulted by Danny Deeds, left him injured. We'll show it right now.
Now, as much as the Abbey's finest trio of Lance Skulls, Danny Deeds, and Todd Quality complained about that three count, while it was shaky from our rookie ref Handsome Pete, that was definitely a three, and Odin Rex got the pin in that tag team match. Deeds would end up getting fined for this actions, and when Pete collapsed out of the ring here, he ended up falling, injuring his wrist. We'll see if he'll be able to ref. He's definitely out of action for November 14th. Fans, at this point in the program, we were supposed to have a few words from our reigning television champion, the OGB, Jordy Taylor. But sometimes technology conspires against us all. So instead, we have a little treat for you. From 2012, here is Jordy's first ever Big West Wrestling match against the legendary Canadian heavyweight, the Mauler.
Okay, here we go, match two. Jordy Taylor. Not endearing himself to the crowd in Kelowna. He has got his work cut out for him tonight. But Jordy's a prize fighter. He's competed in So You Think You're Tough in Nanaimo. He better be tough. Double tough because of this man that's coming out next. There he is.
The match is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, weighing 215 pounds and hauling from the 9-hole, Jordan Taylor! And his opponent, weighing 317 pounds and hauling from Prince Rupert, the Mauler!
Everybody loves the Mauler. Considerable size distance, size difference. I'm just so excited for this matchup. And Jordy Taylor possibly asking for trouble there, mocking the Mauler. I doubt that won't go unpunished.
Now it's your turn, Mauler.
him down. Tit for tat. Taylor is not happy. Crowd is on Taylor's case. Crowd is just razzing this kid. Huge shoulder block. Catches him with a bear. Oh! Bear hug into a spine buster. What an amazing physical specimen is the Mahler and the Senton Splash. That is not fun.
You like that footage?
Quite frankly, Mr. Taylor, we do like that footage. Much needed breather. I'm sure all of the air was knocked out of his lungs with that. What's he doing? Is that a chain in his hand? Sneaking in the ring with that chain. Wait a minute. They don't call him Eagle Eyes for nothing. It's not always for sarcasm. He'll catch something. He just caught that chain. Big shot to the Mahler. Oh, reverse. Kicked ya. Well, you know where the kick was, folks. And then that boot right to the jaw. Johnson was out of position, but Mahler's going to need more than that to take him out. And Jordy's ready to give it. Using that breaking of the rules to get in there. Now he's just on Mahler. Lazy pin. You can't pin a man like that. Especially when he outweighs you by 100 pounds. Now we got some offense here. Smart offense by Jordy Taylor, grinding in that chin lock, wearing the big man down. The size difference like that, you have to do that. Have to do it. Cheap shot again, but it's effective, keeping that big man down. Choking him in the corner. Driving the air out of his lungs. That's what you have to do with a man that big. Keep him winded, wear him down. Obviously with his conditioning, Jordy Taylor will last longer than the Mahler. He just has to get to the point where he can finish him off, and this is the way to do it. Quick cover, hook the leg this time. Still with only a two count. Taylor is frustrated. Got him in the corner. That's not gonna happen. Mahler is fighting off that cross corner whip. Reverse. Oh, but nobody home. Nice neck breaker by Taylor. Back on that offense. Lazy cover. He is not pinning this man correctly. And now just wheeling away. Like I said, the man's a prize fighter. Undefeated in prize fighting competition on Vancouver Island. He is putting those skills to use. Punching and pounding away. Now back to that chin lock. Fans are behind Mahler. He is powering back up. And again pulls him down with a hair. What is this? Taylor serious. He was going to try for a one-foot pin. Is your cup? Did not. Back on the offense goes Taylor. Back to that choke. He is wearing the big man down any way he can. He may not like what he's doing, but it is effective. He is on offense. He has the Mahler on his knees. Oh! revenge for earlier. Big back elbow. Mahler is trying to fire up, trying to get some oxygen in those lungs. Big chop. Taylor's looking to escape, possibly. Oh! Drops him across that top rope, right across the throat. Taylor is crafty. Another cover here. Another two count. Taylor is pulling out all the stops, every trick in the book. The Mahler will not stay down. Fighting back. More shots in the corner by Taylor. He is just an offensive machine right now. Punching, pounding. Another eye rake across the ropes. Anything he can do. The Mahler is standing tough. No, back down. Trying to haul that big man up. That is not easy. Oh, impressive suplex considering the size difference. Ah, oh, barely a one count. Taylor has got to hook him tighter if he's going to pin him. Mahler's trying to get away. Put in a bad position there. Taylor is just standing on him, driving that oxygen out of his lungs, keeping the big man grounded. This is the way you can beat the Mahler, if you can beat the Mahler. He is undefeated since showing up in Big West Wrestling. Up with a clothesline, another back clothesline, and both men are down. We got a collision right there in the center of the ring. Eagle Eyes Johnson on the case. Could we have a double count out right here in the ring? Back in that corner. More big forearms. He's got nasty fists and deadly forearms. Cross corner rip. Mahler comes out with a clothesline. And another one. And a third one. He's fired up. The crowd's got his back. Send him up for the Russian. This is usually... Oh! Taylor holding that rope. That setup usually leads to the big backsplash. Elbow right to the solar plexus. And again with a two count. Taylor sizing him up. Good for the Bulldog. Didn't quite get it all. I don't know if that's enough to put him away. Not with that cover. No way. Kid's gotta hook that leg. Mahler's feeding off the crowd here. They want that big man for Prince Rupert. Oh, we got him. Right there with the Russian. That's usually what... Oh, here we go. The big back splash. Thanks for coming out, Taylor. And that's how you hook a leg. There we go. Impressive contest here. Taylor was in tough, showed his mettle against a much larger opponent. Mahler was able to pull out the victory though, using his size, using his veteran skills to his advantage. And of course that deadly backsplash. Stay tuned for more action, folks. Your winner, the Mahler. We'll be right back.
We'd like to offer a viewer advisory at this point. The match you're about to see is one of the most popular matches in Big West history. However, it does involve someone who has been blackballed from the Pacific Northwest scene for his unacceptable behavior. Rather than punish the other eight people involved, we at Big West have decided to air the match while insisting that the airing of this video in no way, shape, or form condones the behavior of the individual who shall remain nameless. We appreciate your understanding, and we are here to listen to any concerns this match may bring you.
Eight-person tag team match. We have Team Andrews with KC Andrews, KC Spinelli, Ravenous Red and the Natural. And we have Garfield, Felix, Mittens, and Miss Kitty, the Zuma's Cats.
This is sure.
Thank you! Get back!
Go get the ball!
No
young gentleman asked me, where should he go to get trained further? With Colin Cutler and I having to shut down the training school here, there's no place in the Okanagan to get trained full time. Yes, Slave and Black Dragon do the best they can, and yes, there's some spots in Kamloops that maybe you can go work out in my ring, but there's no set school. So this young man asked me, he goes, where do I go to train? And the first thing I said, if you want to still live in the Okanagan, commute down to Lionsgate Dojo and train there as much as you can. Justin Sider's training there and you can see his improvement in leaps and bounds at every show. I said, if you want to move, maybe think about moving to Vancouver Island and train with Eddie Osborne at the 365 Academy. Eddie Osborne is not only one of the best wrestlers in North America today, he's an amazing instructor who's very patient, and his new kids will tell you he will work you hard and fair and make you the best you can be in that ring. This young gentleman said he was thinking of moving to Alberta. And I said, you know what? Go to Top Talent and Heavy Metal. Heavy Metal is without a doubt one of the premier athletes in Alberta today. I have never seen Heavy Metal have a bad match. The guy can do it all. If you're going to go train somewhere, you want to train with a guy who's in the ring every day getting it done. Summerland, right outside the back door of the Howard Simpson Memorial Youth Center. What?
Harold Simpson.
You called it Howard Simpson the whole time.
Just saying. Okay, go again.
Fucking do.
Since I'm already the champion of the goddamn internet, then I'm gonna rant at you for the next week leading to this event, building big ears at Nine West.
And Harold Simpson? Sorry, guy. Sorry, Harold.
Since I'm already the champion of the goddamn internet, then I'm gonna rant at you for the next week leading to this event, building big ears at Nine West.
Try that again. I'm trying to get serious here. So I am here in Summerland, cold as hell, standing outside the Harold Simpson Memorial Youth Center. As this noisy ass truck drives by, because everybody uses this as a thoroughfare.
Hmm.